Give me a chance to respond. Because I'm Muslim, you have said a lot about Islam. Do you understand?
Sir,
you have to be honest.
Do me a favor.
You went that time.
Put the victimhood and the crybaby politics to one side. Okay. Do you understand? I'm speaking factually to you. And I've asked you at each stage, if I'm wrong, then correct me. My argument then is this. What religion, what were the two main religions? I'm not talking about what Muhammad's people, the Quraysh, were worshipping, because we knew they were pagans. Yeah, we absolutely know that as a statement of fact that they were pagans.
Perfect.
So, what were the two dominant religions in that area of the world at that time?
It's the Judaism and in that world, in that time,
yeah,
actually that particular place was, I believe, was the paganism, because these 360 idols, all the Arab those living around used to come there to worship. This is a big festival.
Okay.
So in Arabia, at that time, the biggest religion was speaking
truthfully is difficult for you, so I'll answer the question before you.
No.
Yeah, it's difficult for you.
Hold on. You cannot tell me another religion existed at that time.
Sir,
the main religion in the Arab.
I said, which were the two predominant religions at the time? Let me tell you how I know the answer.
Are you mean that area or the world at that time?
Speaking about
Arabia.
In Arabia. That place that we call Arabia. Just hold on a minute. I'm going to answer it for you, okay. Just so we can cut the time. I don't know. Well, I'm going to tell you, and then I'm going to use Islam to prove what I say.
Okay.
The two predominant religions in that area of the world at the time was Judaism, you understand, and Christianity. Those were the two predominant religions.
What do you mean by dominant? Because wait.
I'm gonna explain to you. You asked the question. Let me explain it to you. Simple. Dominant meaning those which were the biggest religions.
Okay.
By numbers. The biggest religion.
Dominant by numbers.
In terms of influence at that time was Judaism and Christianity.
Okay.
Let me tell you how dominant.
Do you know how many Judaism and Christianity were there? Because the pagans, 360 idols. Every community has an idol around the Kaaba. That's the all Arab used to come there pilgrimage. Do you understand that?
Let me just say to you. Let me just say to you. First and foremost, you're speaking about the Arabs. I'm speaking about the religions that were dominant. I'm going to prove it to you if you keep quiet for 20 seconds. What the dominant religion was, and Islam will prove that what I'm saying is true. When Muhammad allegedly ran out of the cave and he went to Warwick, or his wife, whichever you choose, I don't mind. And he went to Warwick. Do you know what Warwick said? He said, "You have just been spoken to by the angel Jibreel, which is Gabriel." What religion was Warwick?
Huh?
What religion was he?
He was a Christian.
Oh, hold on. So he would have read the Christian books.
Definitely, he was a Christian.
Hold on.
He was the main.
Sir,
main
just answer yes or no.
Main,
answer yes or no.
Yeah.
Was he a Christian?
Yeah.
That's the only reason.
Yeah.
That he knew that it was the angel.
No, I agree with you. Christianity was there.
And so Islam unwittingly makes my point very, very clear.
Yeah, I agree with you.
That suppose, let's just say, for example, let's bring it down kindergarten time. Let's say that Worker wasn't there at the time. What would he have said had happened? Who would have spoken to him?
You are assuming.
I'm not assuming anything.
You are assuming.
Everything that I've told
you is factual. Because he went to Warwick. If Warwick was a Jew, he would have went to the Jew. If Warwick, that's why you're assuming. I cannot answer you that. For me, he went to his wife. His wife took him to Warwick because Warwick and his wife are related. Do you understand that? He went to his wife. And then the wife took him to Warwick. You won't agree that, but we both agree. They went to the We both agree they went to Warwick. So do you understand?
Let me just say to you, I don't care who he went to.
Yeah,
it was Warwick. Hold on. It was Warwick that told him that it was the angel.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Do you understand the implications of that? The implications are this, is that the God that you speak about, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who I say was not heard of. Yeah, he was not heard of. Okay. You're going to say
exactly.
That the creation.
That's why I wanted to ask you the word Abdullah.
You're going to say that.
The word Allah. Is that, you know you're answering my question.
Sir, can I just say all Allah means.
Are you saying that time no Allah existed?
All Allah means. She was the Greek goddess, the Aphrodite.
No, the word Allah.
No, not Allah. And it was the moon god as well. Yeah? As I said, it was Allah. The question that you can't answer me is simply this, which is why I don't like having long conversations with Muslims.
You have been.
Sir, yeah, yeah. No. Only to expose the fallacy of your argument. I'm saying to you that if Muhammad was named at birth Muhammad ibn Abdullah, slave of Allah, and yet the term Allah was not in wide use in Arabia at that time. His parents were futurologists, you understand? Or they knew something that we didn't know. Well, you think about it. How can you be a slave?
I tell you something.
Hold on one moment. How can you be a slave of something that doesn't exist yet?
I tell them something.
You only heard the term Allah. Well, hold on. You only heard the term Allah after the so-called conversation that Muhammad had.
I will answer you that. You said Abdullah.
Muhammad is the prophet of God.
Our prophet's name is Muhammad. That's single name, not two names. Muhammad.
Muhammad ibn Abdullah.
Wait.
There is no serious Muslim.
No.
I challenge any Muslim around here to tell me that is not true.
Wait, you are speaking Arabic. When you say Muhammad ibn Abdullah, it's not English. Do you know the meaning of those three words? Abdullah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. You know these three meanings? They're Arabic, they're not English. To know this, you need to understand the Arabic language. Do you understand? You are speaking Arabic now. It's not English. When you say Muhammad, it's not English. Ibn is not English. Abdullah is forward. They're not English.
Muhammad ibn Abdullah.
What does it mean?
Sir, just one moment. It means slave of Allah.
You know. No, sir, it means Muhammad, son of Abdullah. Ibn means son. So his father's
name. He's the son of a slave.
Exactly.
Well, let me just explain this to you. The Allah that they're speaking about, that Muslims speak about, did not exist at that time.
Why is the father of Muhammad?
Sir.
Where is the father of Muhammad?
Sir, the name of the father. I don't care.
No, I'm asking you.
Yeah? No, I'm going to tell you because this is diversion. You understand?
I'm asking
stick,
you.
Stick to the point.
I'm sticking to the point.
The point is simply this.
Because listen, you don't understand my point.
You carry on speaking.
So,
yeah?
Abdullah means...
You don't want to accept the truth, bro.
Allah. Abdullah.
Let me just say it.
You're not listening. They send Muslims to speak.
Who are not very educated.
Who sent me? No, brother, you are lying now. You are lying. Who sent me? You were here when I came. About four people were here. Do you understand that?
They raise their voice. Anytime anyone comes with a logical argument, they raise their voice
and change
their voice this time and they change.
No. We are four people.
What they cannot do, which is what they seem to misunderstand, because they do not understand the concept of free speech, they do not understand people who think about speech outside of the confines that they give to people. They will say to people, for example, they will say that in Islam there is no compunction. If there is no compunction in religion and there is no compunction in Islam, then why then do you behave the way in which you do? Because you see, one of the problems that most people have here is that they speak about Islam without understanding it. How then do they deal with somebody who does understand it? You understand? Who did follow it? you understand, who speaks a great deal of that language. Islam, as practiced, is nonsensical. In as much the same way that if you say that you are a follower of the Baha'i faith, you can follow that. I actually think that's nonsensical. But you have a right to follow that. What you don't have a right to do is to tell me that I have to follow it, and if I don't, there may well be a chance that I might get hurt if I don't follow it. It's nonsense. Woo.
Nonsense. Total nonsense.
No, no, no. Pardon?
Why not?
Because you can tell
why
me.
Why not? We mean why not?
Hold on, hold on.
Why not?
I can tell you. Because you have a right. This is the concept that most Muslims can't get their heads around. You have a right to believe what you wish to believe. You don't have a right to tell me that I should believe as you believe. I don't believe what you believe.
I believe in something that's noble.
Look,
don't you think
let me just say to you, you know, when my father was alive, my father used to say
to me, word was my.
My father used to say to me,
anytime
a religious person opens their mouth, they're trying to sell you something. You understand? And what it is, most Muslims, if they're honest, and there are very few honest Muslims that I've met, and that's just the truth. I'm just telling you the truth. You understand? Most of the Muslims that you meet, they will tell you if they're honest, yeah, what their aim is. And they say this. If you were to say to a Muslim, well, why don't you go back to your own country? They say that the whole world belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, this is what they say. The whole world belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yep.
They will tell you on one hand that they believe, they will tell you on one hand they will believe in peace. You understand? And how they do it. And yet this man, all he did, he had a conversation with a man, and then all of a sudden he went from Mr. Pius to go and F yourself. You understand what I'm saying to you? So on one hand they preach this tolerance that their book has never preached. You understand? I don't believe in it anymore. I don't. Well, hold on a second. First and foremost, I'm not even speaking to you. And I'll tell you the reason why. When I was in China, here's another Muslim now dressed up in his religious garb, because the world is a stage. I said, you can. I said, did anybody hear what I said?
Yeah.
You're allowed to practice whatever you want to practice.
Yes.
I'm just making a statement. I'm going to tell you because it's a closed. I'm not. I'm speaking generally. This guy turned this time. It's on YouTube. I was sitting down in Chengdu in China, and I heard this guy say to a guy,
you got problem, one-on-one.
Bro.
No, look here, you come with.
When you've got Wallahi,
I'm not afraid of you. Wallahi, I'm not afraid of you. No. Wallahi, I'm not afraid of you. Wallahi, I'm not afraid of you. From day one. No, do you know what? I'm not. What? You batty man, what? Go and do it.
You see, he's not even like that.
Hey, look who you come with.
For your cameras, you
think I'm afraid of you?
Do
something about it.
Two steps back.
Do something. You're a coward. Cyrus Baller. That's Cyrus Gay Club.
So why don't you turn off the cameras and we'll deal with it properly?
No, let's turn off the cameras.
Let's speak properly.
Turn off the cameras. Go to the
mosque. Move me.
Go to Saudi Arabia.
I'm not going nowhere. Move me. I'm not going nowhere. Batty man.
Can I will tell you one thing.
You're a pussy.
The last thing I am is a pussy, my friend. The last thing I am is a pussy. And you want to get a certain reaction out of me? I promise you, you are a big man.
I'm just telling you what I saw.
Yeah.
This is the same man that said to a man, hold on,
Sarah.
Hold on a minute. Either I'm telling the truth or I'm not telling the truth. Let's just stand on the truth. Stand on the truth. Then the man says to a man, I've been in jail, and where I come from, if somebody speaks about the Prophet, he knows man them who'll shut them. They can talk like that to man them who are some idiots. You understand? They can chat to man like that who's idiots. What if you're not an idiot? Then you're going to have to back that talk up. And this is what I'm saying to you. My view, and I'll say it again, if you wish to be Muslim, that is fine. I'm not here to tell you shouldn't be Muslim. Yeah, if you want to be Christian, I'm not here to tell you that you're not to be Muslim. But most people don't understand that what they do, Hyde Park is not what Hyde Park was. Hyde Park, as I said, has become an open-ear mosque, and what they wish to do is to come here every week and proselytize. There is nothing wrong with that, but I don't accept it.
Me neither.
And so certain people who come with that wicked talk and tell people that man's going to get shot, and they can't chat to me. And boy,
perfect. That's true. Yeah, big bro.
Can't chat to me. Can't chat to me. Stop. You don't know what democracy is. Come on,
Don't worry.
This happens all the time.
Stop running. Why are you running? Go the babe, bro.
Why are you lying? Who did I say I'm gonna shoot?
You said to Sarah that he's a bad man.
Why?
Sir, hold on 1 second.
One minute.
Yes. When a man, because I'm telling you, if you told me that, okay. I'd war with you.
Okay, war with
you. I'm just telling you, sir, hear what I'm saying. When somebody
goes to engage in an argument with somebody, and the first thing that this person says is, hold on, you're a batty man.
I'm not trying to you. You can say what you want.
Let him speak.
I don't want to
speak to them. What are you running for? Speak to me.
You're a coward.
I know, I'm not.